Hi, my name's Andrew Fairley, and today I'm going to cook Albert Bartlett's Red Rooster Potato Bacon and Gruyere Cake. The Gruyere cheese is fantastic for this recipe because it's a great cooking cheese. It doesn't let out any fat once it's cooking. And then I'm going to use some smoked pancetta. If you don't have pancetta, then streaky bacon works equally as well. So what I have here, I've got some rooster potatoes which I've peeled already. Now I'm just going to slice these thinly using this piece of equipment here. It's a mandolin. Slice potato, just about that thickness is perfect. So we're just going to slice the rest of these potatoes. Okay, so here we have probably roughly about 1 kilo of sliced potatoes. And here I've got the Gruyere cheese, which I've already grated. So now we're going to build the cake. So what I have here is a non-stick frying pan. I'm just going to lightly butter the bottom and the edges of the pan. And now I'm just going to line the pan with some of the pancetta. You can get the really thin pancetta. So if you can ask your butcher, or you can now buy this in supermarkets pre-sliced. And it's important at this point, just leave the overhang of pancetta over the edge of the pan. What we're going to do is we're going to then fold that so the potato and the cheese is completely enclosed. As I say, for a cold winter's evening, for a supper dish, I would normally eat this with a nice crisp green salad, or even to eat on its own as a kind of snack. Okay, so there we have the frying pan, completely lined with the bacon. Now we're going to start to build the potatoes. So we're just going to layer the potatoes. I think it's nice to keep the potatoes in an even layer. And what we're going to do is basically we're going to repeat this 3 or 4 times. So in between each layer of potato, we're just going to put a thin layer of the cheese. Now I would probably season this every second layer because sometimes the pancetta can be a little bit salty. But what I do like is lots of black pepper. Again, just to show the versatility of rooster potato, it holds its shape beautifully in this particular recipe. Okay, so that's the last layer of potato there. So again, I'm just going to season that with a little bit of black pepper. And then I'm just going to start to fold the bacon over the potato just so it's nice and tucked in. Okay, so what I'm going to do there is just to finish with a few more rashers of pancetta just to make sure all the potatoes are enclosed in the bacon. So that's our potato cake with the bacon. Now what I'm going to do with that now, I'm just going to start it off on the hob just to get the bottom of the bacon nicely golden brown. So that's the cake just starting to fry in the pan, so you can just see the bacon starting to sizzle around the outside. So probably about 4 or 5 minutes on a kind of medium to high heat. So that's the cake, 4 or 5 minutes on the stove just to start the bacon cooking, and I'm just going to now put this into the oven. Okay, so that's the potato cake. It's been in there for about 50 minutes now, so it's nice and tender. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to leave that in the pan for about 10 minutes just to rest it a little bit, just so the potatoes soak up all the bacon fat and everything, and then we can turn it out onto the plate. Okay, so that's the cake being rested for about 10 minutes, so I'm just going to turn it out onto the plate. Okay, so I'm just going to slide that onto the board. So there we have the layers of potato with the layers of Gruyere cheese in between. As I say, we can leave that to cool. It's a great picnic thing or a snack thing. It's almost like a tortilla. So the potatoes have got the smokiness of the bacon and the mild Gruyere cheese going through it. So there we have a Red Rooster potato, bacon and Gruyere cake.